Hey up everyone, welcome back to the channel. And I'm sporting a black eye. But that ain't because someone's done me on sight. That's because I bent down and smacked it on a light. At least that's what I'm telling people. No, that's the truth. So we're on a timber frame job. There's a few things, a lot of things actually, that you need to set up right to start with. So I'm going to show you a few things just to get you going a bit quicker when you get on the jobs. First thing is, when you're setting up, it's irrelevant where you want to put your brickwork, because the timber frame is already up, so you're governed on this. So whatever this is and whatever the cavity size says, that's what you go to, unless it's stupidly out and then you need to tell the site manager that it needs changing. But once the building's up, which this building is up, and it's a big apartment block, you go to that. So what we're going to do is we're going to range off this with a level, come off your board, and then you're going to set your profile out to whatever the cavity is to suit it. So these are 75mm cavities, so we do 75. Luckily, the splash course isn't in. If the splash course was in, you would have to send this from wherever the point was down on the floor, and you'd work it in, and you'd have to build it out of plumb. However, the splash course isn't in, so what we can do when it's a little bit out here and there, you just pull it away. So I'll show you this little bit. That's from the timber work. That's how far it's out, maybe 8mm. So we're gonna, so I've plumbed down off the top of my foot frame, plumb this down to bring that plumb, and then put the lines through it, and then you can see that's pretty straight down there actually. But there's little bits around here that I need bringing off to suit the framework. Then all the levels. Make sure you've got your levels sorted for what you need, your compression sizes for under your silt, stuff like that. So we've had an engineer go around, and we've got, there we go, I'll show you. We're going to go around and put what we need to get up to get to the splash, top of the splash course. So it's plus 16 there, whereas down this end is only plus 10. I'll get all the levels sorted, and then I go around, mark them up to where finished floor level is, and then I can gauge up from there. We're governed by the tops of the window heads anyway. So once you've got your splash in, once that splash is in and it's level, perfect all the way around, and you've got everything plumbed down, then you can start laying bricks. But it's important that you start the building off right, rather than trying to lean stuff in, lean stuff out and all that lot. And then you're good. We've got all the drawings sorted now. We've got all the levels sorted now. We've got the lines set up. All we're waiting for is a pump in for the silo. That's about an hour away, and then we'll be good to go. It's been bloody cold here today again, but we do have some air bricks to put in retrospectively, which is going to be a bit of a pain. Other than that, I think we're pretty good to go. Okay, so yesterday we managed to get the brickwork up on a panel, but it was going dark, so I didn't get any more footage for you. I'll turn you around and show you. We've got this with a meter box here, ran to a movement joint, and we did this little panel here. Today we're going along and we're setting all of the splash course with the vents. So we're getting that across. This morning we pulled down this section, and I'll show you where we're going to. We've done down this little section, done in here. Inside these doorways has got a curb stone to go in, so we've left them down. Pulling across, we've pulled down this little section, and we're just down it to this little bit. What we're doing is 180 lines, 75mm cavity. We're pulling out these little gallows brackets just for the splash, so I don't have to move all my big profiles across. And then we're running this across, and I'm just marking out where my air bricks are going now. And then we're just going to continue down all this back for as far as we go till we meet the other gang. The other gang are going down the other side, So we've started across the front and down the side. They've started just down the side and the back. And this is a nice straight run down here now. So it shouldn't be too difficult. And all we're doing is we're plumbing down, resetting all these footings to make sure they work with the frame, and then it'll work lovely for the cavity sizes. And we shouldn't have much leaning in and out, hopefully. There's not a lot more you need to know on these, really. So we'll see how far we get down this. Paco's leaning all the time. He's leaning out. One of the things that we've showed him is make sure everything goes to the frame sizes. So your bond always comes in with your frames. For you out there, these are where you put your ties on them marks. And I've marked up for me air bricks. I've just gone off the ends and marked them up on the walls, and I've also put what the difference in height is from the underneath subs. It's 17 mil pickup, so we just do that in the first course, pick that up with a stiff bed, and then we can go gauge for the next two courses. And then when we come up to the top of the splash and go off with the profiles, it's all good gravy. Yeah, man, that was a lot of hard graft today. Backs in two because of bending down three courses all the way around. We met the other brickies down the bottom end. All we left really was two little indents and two little indents to the doorways, and not a lot else. But it was getting dark. We need to get jointed up. The mortar doesn't go off so quick in this weather, and the bricks don't take any mortar up because they're concrete. But I'm absolutely knackered now today. Fire stocks have come in. That's what we've been waiting for, so we can carry on, at least do some of the supers now. And the windows are due Monday, so we're just going to have to build up to the structural openings, and that's all we can do. If you've enjoyed today's video, give us a like, subscribe to the channel if you're not already, and we'll see you in the next one. Keep it nice and easy. Daryl, Daryl, Daryl.